गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट दि स्टैटिकली इंडिटर्मिनेट फ्रेम और ए रिडंडेंट फ्रेम. सो हाउ टू सॉल्व दि फोर्स इन ए मेंबर्स ऑफ स्टैटिकली इंडिटर्मिनेट फ्रेम एज शोन इन फिगर. सो दिस इज द क्वेश्चन गिवन इन प्रीवियस क्वेश्चन पेपर. ओके, सो हाउ टू सॉल्व दिस पर्टिकुलर रिडंडेंट फ्रेम. सो वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस दि कास्टिग्लियानो सेकंड थ्योरम, the partial derivative of a strain energy with respect to the redundant force. So then we'll give the minimum. So minimum stands for it is equals to zero. So based upon Castigliano's second theorem, the formula will finally appeared. S is equals to P plus X into K. So what is the X here? So summation of PK L by AE and summation of K square L by AE. So what is the P and what is the K here? So we already discussed in the deflection of a truss member. So how to solve the deflection of truss member? In that particular concept we discussed. So what is this P and what is this K value? So here the P is the member forces appeared due to the, what are the loads given in a cushion or what are the loads applied on a truss member. And what is the K force? So by applying the unit force in a particular truss, okay, what are the unit force we are going to apply to a truss? So for that unit load, what is the member forces will appear? That is the K forces. Okay, so after getting this P value and K value and substitute in this formula, and finally we'll get the X value, and substitute the X value in this formula, finally we get the S, actual forces in a member. This is the just explanation about the formula. So we should not focus on this formula, how to get this one. Okay, just leave it is. Okay, then we'll move to the question. So what is the question and what are the dimensions they are giving? So here it is a 2 meters the span. So both are in 2 meters, height is 2 meters and length is also 2 meters. So how to get this diagonal length? So it is an 45 degrees. How to get this 45 degrees? So when you take the tan 45 degrees or tan theta is equals to opposite side by adjacent side. So this is opposite side and this is adjacent side. So this is adjacent side and this is opposite side. Then we'll get the angle value, angle that is theta is equal to 45 degrees. Why? Because is the length is 2 meters and height is also 2 meters. So finally we got theta is 45 degrees. I didn't mention here. So here theta is 45 degrees. And what about this angle? Or what about this, length of this diagonal member? So when you apply the Pythagoras theorem, so h square is equal to ab square plus bc square, then we will get this length, that is 2 root 2 will appear. Okay. So directly I am moving to the first step. So first of all, the particular truss is indeterminate or not? Let me check it is. So m plus r minus 2j be the formula for checking statically indeterminate structure. So how to check it is? So what, how many members we are having? So here I mentioned in blue ink. So 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. And what about the reactions? Actually here I mentioned reactions are 4. So for pin jointed trusses the reactions is only 3. So but this particular formula is only applicable if the structure is, or if the truss is like this only, this 4 will appear. In some trusses they directly mentioned, so one is hinged, other end is roller. So if the one end is hinged, other end is roller, the reaction will be 3 only. But so when the structure is like this, so we have to take the 4 reactions. And how many joints we are having? 1 2 3 4 5. So that finally we got the 1. So entire truss is a statically indeterminate truss. So when you remove the one member, so when you remove this one member, either AC or CE, any member in the particular truss, then it is equals to the statically determinate. So let me check. So I removing this BC member. I am removing BC member. just observe the figure. So the figure will appear like this. So when I am removing the BC member, so while you substituting the members, how many members we got? 6. Reaction will be 4, and minus 2, 5 is 10. So finally 10 minus 10, 0 will appear. So finally the structure will turns into the statically determinate. Okay, so this is the procedure we have to follow. So first of all, you have to check whether it is statically determinate or statically indeterminate. So if it is indeterminate, you have to make it as determinate. The structure is given in the question is it is indeterminate only, but you have to turn into determinate structure after removing any diagonal member. So diagonal member is easy to follow. Okay, either AD or BC, whatever it may be, you can remove. So I am removing here BC member. So that's why here I mentioned we will consider one of the diagonal members, diagonal member BC as redundant. Redundant means extra. So when you removing that one, the finally the structure is in statically determinate structure. So then, so what are the just reactions? What are the reactions we'll get due to the this 20 kilonewtons? So due to this 20 kilonewtons, what are the reaction force will appear at A and B? So then just go to the, so take the horizontal reactions at A and B. So taking moments about A is equal to 0. So here I mentioned the arrows. Here the VA is acting like this. Here VB also is acting in upward direction. So but it is in along the AB portion. So that's why I am mentioning VA directly. I am mentioning only vertical force is VA. So when you take the horizontal reactions at B, what are the moments will come up to the A? HB into perpendicular distance. So perpendicular distance is 2 meters. And here it is 20 kilonewtons is up, is there. So 20 into like this. So 20 into perpendicular distance, that is clockwise direction, 20 into 2. And here it is also 20 kilonewtons. So 20 into 4 meters. So actually here it is some mistake. This is not 20, 2 meters. So 20 into 4. Just you observe in this sketch. Okay. So 20 into 4 meters up to the A point. So finally we got the HB is equals to 60 kilonewtons. It is moving in right side, towards the right side. So when we should give the stability condition, or when we go for the stability condition, HB is moving in this direction, automatically you should consider HA is in this direction only due to the stability condition. So if the load if the HA is acting in towards right side, when you consider HA is in towards left side, the entire system is in stability condition only. Okay, when you take the vertical reaction, so VA is equals to upward force equal to downward forces, 20 plus 20, the final is equals to 40 kilonewtons will be appear. This is the force which is acting at the point A. And the remaining procedure is the similar to, so what are the deflection of thrust we consider? And the same thing here also we follow the procedure. So here, now I am moving to the calculation of P forces. So how to calculate the P forces? So we are having two methods, that is method of joint and method of section. We already discussed in engineering mechanics. Okay, and the same procedure here also we are following. So first of all, I am taking the joint E. So why I am taking the joint E? Just your observe here the two forces are unknown and one force is known here. So that's why I am choosing the joint E. Okay, just to follow the arrows like this. I already mentioned in the deflection of truss. Okay, you just follow like this only. So at the joint E, so the force is PEC and PED. So both are going in left side direction and 20 kilonewtons. The given in question is downward direction. So when you go for the sigma V is equal to 0. So what is the sigma V is equal to 0? Vertical forces are equal to 0. So 20 kilonewtons is acting downwards and the PEC acting in upward direction. What about the vertical component? That is sine. So therefore PEC sine 45 degrees equals to 20, and finally PEC is equal to 20 root 2. So that is positive will come. Here I am taking the positive as tensile force. So in some textbooks they are given in tensile as negative. Okay, and we'll go for the sigma H is equal to 0. What is the sigma H is equal to 0? Horizontal forces is equal to 0. Both are acting in towards left side direction. Okay, there is no any right side direction forces. That's why I am summation PED plus PEC cos 45. Why I am writing here cos 45? So the horizontal component is cos 45 is equal to 0. So finally I got PED is equals to minus 20 kilonewtons. So here minus will appear, so that's why I mentioned here compressive force. Okay, then move to the joint C. Just observe, here it is joint C. So this is the force, and AC and CE members will comes. So just observe joint C. Okay, and the same procedure, sigma V is equal to 0 and sigma H is equal to 0. So when you take the arrows like this, so at the point the forces are acting downwards, we have to mention arrows like this, and left side we have to mention like this only, and sigma V is equal to 0. So finally we got PCD towards downwards, and PC is also towards downwards, and component is 45 degrees, sine 45, and finally PCD is equal to minus 20. The force is compressive force, and sigma H is equal to 0. So this is in towards left side direction, and this is in towards right side direction. So that's why I mentioned, so one force is towards left and one force is towards right. So finally we got 20 kilonewtons. So 20 kilonewtons tensile force. Okay, so then we will move to the joint A. So here all member forces are completed, only this is AD, and next one BD is only the pending to calculation. Okay, so then we will move to the joint A. Here the loads are acting, here the member forces are meeting like this. Just to take sigma V, why? Because either sigma V or either sigma H, both are the correct, but I am taking here sigma V is equal to 0. What are the vertical forces we'll get? So that is VA is acting in upward direction, and PAD is acting in downward direction, which makes a sine component. Why? Because vertical component is sine, we have to take. So PAD sine 45 degrees is equal to 40, and finally PAD is equals to 40 root 2 tensile will appears. And when we will go to the joint B, here it is the joint B. So HB force is acting like this, and BD force is acting like this. So don't consider this is as member. Okay, starting only I have to explain this one, I forgot this one. Don't take this AB as a member, it is not a member. Okay, so joint B, so both are acting towards right side direction, so that's why I am taking summation 60 plus PBD is equals to 0, and finally I got the PBD is equal to minus 60 kilonewtons compression. So this is the P forces. So how to get the P forces? Whatever the loads are given in a question, or whatever the loads are acting to a truss, for that loads what are the member forces will appear, will calculated that one. So this is the diagrammatic representation of tensile forces and compression forces. So compression forces are, here the arrows are going towards the joint, that is the compression, and if the arrows away from the joint, so this is the arrow which away from the joint, this the member is tension, and if the arrows is towards the joint, the member is in compression. You have to mention like that only. I think you already know in engineering mechanics. And then we'll go to the how to calculate the K forces. This is the some typical aspect to calculate the K forces. So what is the procedure involving to calculate the K forces? Just whatever the member forces we remove, here the BC member forces is extra force, so we remove that force only while calculating the P. But when we calculate the K forces, we have to remove all the loads which are acting in a truss, that is 20 kilonewtons are acting here, and at the D point also 20 kilonewtons is acting. We have to remove the all forces, and when you go for the BC member, when you take the BC member as unit load, so like this we have to apply. I will show you in the figure. Just observe here the unit member force I am applying in the member of BC. So whatever you choose for the redundancy, for that only you have to take the 1 kilonewtons. So that 1 kilonewtons, either it may be compression or either it may be tension, so whatever it may be you can choose. So here I am taking the member force BC is in compression, so here the arrows are moving towards the joint, so that's why the member is in compression. Okay, So here clearly I am mentioned. Now given, remove the given load system and apply the pair of unit force, so that is 1 kilotons at the B and C in the place of BC as shown in figure. And since the force balance themselves, there will be no reaction, sir. So here we are removing all the loads which are acting on a truss. Just observe here, there is no any force, any external force which are acting in the truss member. So that's why there is no any reaction force which appears at the A and B. We should not concentrate on the reaction. Why? Because there is no any external force which is acting. So while calculating the K forces, we can remove the all external forces. Okay, then we'll start the procedure for calculating the K. So just I mentioned some logical, and next one shortcuts. So these two are used in gate point of view also. If the joint is here and the two member forces are meeting like this, only two unknown forces are meeting at a joint. There is no any force, only two forces, that is unknown. If the two unknown forces are meeting at this joint, that particular two forces, member forces value is zero. That is the logic and that is the shortcut you have to remember. So again I am repeating, this is the joint. Okay, at that particular joint the two forces are meeting like this, only two unknown forces. If you take like this, the two unknown forces are zero. So if you calculate, then finally we got the zero. So just to keep it in mind, this is a shortcut. And next one, if it is a joint, these three forces are meeting like this. So these two acting exactly 180, and this is the force which is acting exactly in perpendicular direction. So for this case, this particular member force is zero. This is one of the shortcut to find out the member forces. So that's why here at the point E, these two forces are meeting. So I am consider CE and DE forces are zero. Okay, so just observe here, KEC is equal to KED is equal to zero. Okay, you should not focus on this two member forces. Then I will move to the calculation of remaining forces. Just I am taking the C joint. Just observe here, C joint. The same procedure will repeat. So C joint, here the KCA, KBC. So here KBC, we already take the arrow. We already took the arrow in compression. So here arrow is acting in upward direction or towards the joint. So you should not change that arrow. Okay. Here I am taking arrow is upward direction. When you consider the sigma V is equal to 0, KBC sine 45 degrees, and here the KCD is acting in downward direction, and finally KCD is equal to 1 by root 2 tensile. And when you take the sigma H is equal to 0, so this is going in left side direction and this one is going in right side direction. Finally KCA is equals to 1 by root 2 tensile. As the same thing for joint D also. Here the joint D, so that is AD and BD only will appear. So when you consider the sigma V is equal to 0 and next one sigma H is equal to 0, when you consider like this, so finally KDA is equals to minus 1 by 1 kilonewton compression, and KBD is equals to 1 by root 2 kilonewtons tension. When you table it like this, what are the members which appear in the truss? AC, CE, ED, DB, DC, AD and BC. And what are the P forces which appears after removing the BC member as redundancy? So when you removing the BC member as redundancy, these are the forces will appear. Here we are removing the BC, so that's why I am considering. So we have to consider, not I am, we have to consider the zero. Okay, then we will go to the K forces. What is the K forces? So when you removing all the external forces which are acting on a truss, that is the K forces, then we apply 1 kilonewton member force in the redundancy. So here it is 1 kilonewton. So why I am mentioned here minus? The force is in compression. So that's why here I mentioned minus. And what are the loads? So we'll get, I have written in this table. And what are the length of the member? 2 meters. And diagonal member is 2 root 2. And ADBC also 2 root 2. So when you product P into K and L, finally I got, this is the expression. When you take the summations, summation of this entire forces, finally I got this one. So finally I got this one, And next one, this is the sigma k square l. This is the summation of sigma k square l. So this is minus 20 root 2, 3 plus 4 root 2. Here it is 3 plus 4 root 2. Okay, when you take the x, what is the x formula? We already defined in the starting. Summation of pk l by ae, summation of k square l by ae. Here in the question, they directly given, just observe. So as shown in figure, under the action of forces, the cross section of area of the each bar is 1000 mm square and is 2 into 10 power 5 newton per mm square. So entire area of the each member is equal, and Young's modulus also equal, so that you should not concentrate in the tabular column. So here I didn't mention in the table what is the area of the member and what is the Young's modulus of the member. Why? Because each and every member area is same and Young's modulus is also same. So I am not mentioned in the table. So directly AE AE get cancelled, and finally we got summation of PKL by summation of K square L, and finally I got the X, that is correction factor, that is some correction, X equal to plus 20 root 2. So final forces, that is final force for any member, actual force S is given by P plus 20 root 2 into K. If you calculate the actual force in the member AC, you should add PAC and KAC. So we already calculated what is the PAC, this is plus 20, KAC plus 1 by root 2. Just to substitute in this formula. So PAC is plus 20 and KAC is 1 by root 2. So finally I got 40 kilonewtons, that is tension. As the same thing for SCE. So PCE, KCE. So KC value is 0 and PC value is 20 root 2. And finally I got 20 root 2. And SED is equals to, SED means here PED and KED. So PED is minus 20, KED is 0. And finally I got minus 20. So here minus will appear, so that's why I mentioned compression. Like that you have to calculate the all remaining forces in truss member. So this is the procedure to calculate the redundant member forces in a truss. So finally I conclude. So what are the steps involved to calculate the following truss? Okay, so first of all you have to calculate the frame or truss, whether it is statically determinate or indeterminate. So first of all you have to calculate that one. So and next one, so if you got the statically indeterminate, then you can get the statically determinate. You can make a statically indeterminate into the statically determinate. That is the second step. Okay, then after you calculate the P forces due to the external force which is applied on a truss member. Okay, then after we have to calculate the K forces. How to get the K forces? Just remove the all member forces. All the external forces which are acting at the joints. Okay, and next take the redundant force as 1 kilonewtons. Apply 1 kilonewtons in the redundancy. Where you remove that redundancy, at that only you have to apply 1 kilonewton. That 1 kilonewtons, either it may be compression or either it may be tension. So whatever you choose, so nothing will wrong. Okay, so and then follow the method of joint procedure and finally the tablet them and calculate the X value and calculate the final S value. So this is the procedure. Okay, in some truss problems they didn't mention like this. Just observe, in some truss problems they didn't mention like this AB. So they directly given, so one is hinge support, another one is roller support. You should follow whatever the reaction will give. Only this AB member, if the question will be like this only, you have to take the reactions as 4. Okay, you just keep it in mind. Okay, so thank you. Then we will continue the next problem in next video lecture. Thank you.